first got ordained, I moved to Brooklyn. I didn't know anyone. I didn't have a church. I didn't have a building. They showed me, the bishop's assistant showed me the neighborhood and said, have fun. So from the Lutheran tradition, everyone is considered to be simultaneously a sinner and a saint. And so the people we call saints are the people aren't necessarily better than other people, just the people who, in that moment, we see the divine reflected.
A parish refers to a sort of community around which a congregation or a pastor or a priest serves. What Lutherans would call a diocese, we call a synod, and it comes from Greek. It's composed of two parts, syn, S-Y-N, from which we get synergy, or it literally means with, and then odos, from which we get odometer. Odos means road or path or way. And so a synod is a group of people who travel the way together. And actually the earliest reference to followers of Jesus are not called Christians. But the earliest people who follow Jesus are called followers of the way. It's been a struggle to find that balance between the ancient and the modern, because people really hunger for the ancient, for that which has sustained generations through hardship and struggle and given them hope in the midst of despair. But at the same time, they don't want a tradition that only sustained people in the past. They need it to sustain them now. You look back at your past week and you look at those places in your week that have given your life, that have made you feel connected, that draw you closer to the divine. And Ignatius talks about those places as places of consolation. And then at the same time, you also notice those places in your past week where you have felt abandoned or desolate, despair, those places that have drawn you away from the divine. And Ignatius calls those places of desolation. And we learn from both.
Here, stand by the door that you helped paint. You painted that section?
As a movement, really took hold in Mexico after the Mexican Revolution in the early 20th century. And it's very much a way to express ideology, for lack of a better word, or explore social issues in a public way. Through art. And so, as compared to, I guess, other mural traditions, which might just be about sort of pretty pictures, muralism is really about grappling with what's going on in a society and putting that up on the walls to make the struggles of a neighborhood public, or the hopes of a neighborhood public. Usually there's some sort of issue that inspires people to create a mural. Here we go. This is much more about the problems in the neighborhood. Domino Sugar, big factory here in Williamsburg that employed a lot of people. It's now in the process of being turned into housing. And so there's been a big struggle within the neighborhood to make sure that it's affordable housing and doesn't just go to very rich people. Debated this issue, no one knows, and I personally think that probably every sneaker is thrown up for a different reason. I've heard everything from kids graduate, or when kids get beat up, or this is where you buy drugs, or like when someone gets home from the army, or like, you know, like, or just kids are bored.